station on Space to Ground.
Cargo inbound and crew outbound. Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. SpaceX's 11th Dragon will soon be headed to the International Space Station. The cargo capsule's flight was delayed a bit, but soon it'll launch atop a Falcon 9 from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It's packed with nearly 6,000 pounds of science and supplies for the International Space Station, including materials for dozens of new experiments. Dragon will arrive at station a few days after launch, and NASA's Jack Fisher and Peggy Whitson will be ready with the Canada Arm 2 robotic arm to reach out and capture it. We'll be sure to highlight some of the exciting science being delivered in the weeks to come, studying everything from human health to neutron stars. And after 196 days in space, two Expedition 51 crew members returned home on Friday. ESA astronaut Tomas Pesquet and Russian cosmonaut Oleg Novitsky touched down in Kazakhstan to wrap up their stay in space. This was the first flight for Pesquet and the second for Novitsky, who now has 340 days in space. They launched back in November along with Peggy Whitson, who had her stay extended, remaining on board until September when she'll take the empty seat in the Soyuz with Jack Fisher and Fyodor Yurchikhin. This week's Twitter question comes from Nick, who wanted to know how many people are usually up in space at a time. Well, it just changed with this landing, but we'll be back at full strength this summer. Right now, there are only three people in space, Peggy Whitson, Jack Fisher, and Fyodor Yurchikhin. Then three new crew members will launch at the end of July and get us back up to our usual population of six. In the not-too-distant future, though, U.S. commercial crew vehicles will enable us to add another crew member, bumping the station crew up to seven. An important factoid to remember, though, we've had at least two humans in space every single day since November 2000. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.